more than 1 billion people suffer from disability caused by neurologic disease, whether it's a stroke, dementia, accident, or some other problem. That's more than 1 in every 6 people on Earth. But neurologic disability is a solvable problem. I'm Melanie Walker. I'm an endovascular neurosurgeon at the University of Washington. Estimates are that neurologic disability costs us between $200 billion and $1 trillion a year, maybe more. It destroys families, it destroys personal life, and it destroys opportunity. And it's completely unnecessary. Most people don't know that if you present to a hospital within 24 hours of a stroke, there's a very good chance that we can reverse the disability from that stroke. We can perform a very simple surgery called a mechanical thrombectomy for stroke patients. We insert a small catheter in their arm or their leg and use arteries as roadways to get to the brain and remove the clot that's causing the obstruction to blood flow. By doing that, we can reverse the symptoms that they're having. It may be weakness, it may be difficulty talking, or it may be more severe. We can do that today. New science is emerging, and my colleagues and I are hopeful that within the next 5 years, we can offer new treatments to start reversing neurologic disability for more people in more places. Almost every cell in the human body has little batteries inside of it, and those batteries are called mitochondria. Mitochondria aren't so different than the batteries you find in your smartphone. In fact, sometimes when your phone is really low on charge, it seems like it's broken. It's not your phone that's broken, it just needs a little boost. Same thing goes for your cells. Sometimes when we assume that a tissue is dying or dead, maybe what it needs is a little bit of energy. My colleagues and I believe that we can take mitochondria from healthy cells and replace them into sick cells in your heart, your brain, your kidneys, and other organs that may be lacking in energy. Our hope is that by re-implanting batteries into tissues that don't have energy, we can restore function. We've seen many exciting examples. In the heart, people who've had heart attacks, when we re-implant healthy mitochondria, we see that the tissue regenerates and gives the heart a new chance to beat another bunch of years. In the case of a stroke, we would simply deliver mitochondria beyond the place of the clot into the tissue that's starved of energy. Our hope is that we can make it part of the standard of care. But one of the challenges that we face is that the new technologies are moving very, very quickly, and we need more doctors that are able to perform procedures like this. So we're working on that, and I'm hopeful that in the next few years we'll have more and more capacity to start reversing neurologic disability in cities all around the world. We're never going to stop all disease. We're never going to be able to prevent every accident. But imagine a world where you don't have to live with neurological disability as a result of those. I believe it can happen.